excited over a couple things. My voice is back. And we are all here. And that, to me, is the most exciting thing that we have on this evening, because it is an incredibly powerful, wonderful, awesome evening to be together as a people of faith in God, worshiping. Before we do move into our worship, there are some basic announcement things to remind you of or let you know about. First is, if you have one of these magic communication devices, I think we're up to like, what, 27G or something like that now. Make sure it's set for stun. In fact, let me double check mine real quick, just because when mine goes off, it sounds like a bell ringing. Angels getting wings and all that. The other thing is, should we have, and this is unexpected, but should we have an unexpected water landing during the worship service, the exits are located to the back. Two sides. So again, unexpected water landing during the worship service. Exits are located to the side and to the back of the sanctuary space. So you make note of those. When we get ready to sing our final song, we will be lighting candles. So make sure you've got one. If you don't have one, we'll try to get one to you during the service. Also, congregation, be aware that there is a part of heavy lifting that you will get to do tonight besides singing. You will be taking part in one of the scripture readings. It will be projected on the walls here when we get to that moment. Question? Outside of that, I don't believe there's any other announcements to be made. I will say welcome again, and let us join our hearts together as one as we turn toward God in prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks for this space and this time to gather in. We are grateful for the people that we are gathering with, for the lights, for the sound, for the smells of the season. We're grateful for your Son, for we have come on this Advent journey to this place. We are anticipating, O God, anticipating not only the celebration of a birth that took place so long ago, but anticipating the return. And so we gather and worship again. We gather and we worship, O God. We glorify you in thought and in word and in praise. We gather and we bring with us a great community of our hearts and minds, those who are physically present and those whose absence we are feeling last night. And with all the clouds of witness, with all the saints of the church, with all those that are here, we join our voices together, O God, worshiping you and praying to you, using the words that your Son gave us, praying together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
1969, auspicious year, anniversary year, right? 50 years ago. Let's see, great things happened. Moon landing happened, 1969. Sesame Street happened in 1969. What else? Woodstock. Yeah, so a few knowing headlines there. Yeah. The Stonewall Riot, the Beatles performing on top of Apple Records. 1969. Oh, one more auspicious thing took place in 1969. These two college sweethearts got married. And a handful of years later, they would have a child. A couple years after that, they'd have another child, a beloved son, that's me. This year, my parents celebrated 50 years of the wedding. 1969, 100 years ago, we're going back a little bit further now, Prohibition
We're nodding heads, yeah. Yeah, not that crowd, okay. League of Nations, the Treaty of Versailles, officially ends World War I. What if we go back even further? 1819. There's this little school that's founded out in the western part of the state. You may have heard of it. They've, the football team is so-so. Mr. College here, yeah. University of Virginia is founded in 1819. What if we go back another 100 years? 1719, 300 years ago. A hymn writer begins jotting down words having been inspired. And over the coming decades, hymn will come into its fullness. It is our hymn of praise. So let us join our voices to sing joy to the world. Please stand as the Spirit moves.
The case of the formless void and the cascading world cast a long shadow. The light fills the corners of the room and we breathe easy. We gather in peace.
The season is filled with music and life. We're also reminded of the absences and the grief. We are greeted again by God with us, and our mourning is turning once more into dancing. We gather in joy.
The single light becomes four, and a sense of completeness emerges. We are aglow. We are warmed by the Spirit. We gather in love.
From the four lights, the four directions, the four points of creation, a fifth light emerges. The anticipation yields expectation. The expectation shocks us with reality. God with us. Emmanuel, the Christ, the anointed of God, has come again into the world and into our life. We are gathered to God. Thanks be to God.
Please join us in the congregational response. Forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Makes them even more important. What's the point of writing something down and putting it on the shelf where it's never read, right? So the most important stories are written down, and then we pull them off the shelf and we share them. This is a collection of important stories.
The Bible?
Collection of important stories.
The Bible?
It should be pulled off the shelf and shared. Yes, it's the Bible. Now, this is actually a new Bible. I've got boxes of these in my office right now. And we're going to be replacing the Bibles that are in the sanctuary space. So, after the new year, if you were to come in and look, you would find these Bibles. They're a little more readable than the ones we have. Because if you're going to tell a story and read it, it should be readable, right? But I have one, and this is where you all get to do the most important thing. We need to dedicate these Bibles. We need to say these Bibles are special, and we're going to do something special with them, right? So this is where you all get to help. Right? So this is what I want to do. I want you to come up this way. I'm going to ask you to sit down. Come on. We're going to form a circle. We're going to form a circle, okay? Come on. Form a circle. All right. I'm going to sit down because I'm older. I'm going to hold it out. I'm going to invite you to put your hands on it. Okay? You can touch it. Yeah, touch that Bible. Touch that Bible. Almighty God, we pray that these stories might be our stories, and that this book might be a book that is shared with the world. We ask this, O God, that we might all come to know you better through Jesus the Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Excellent. Thank you so very much. You all just thank you.
Thanks be to God. The second lesson is from Isaiah 9, 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with the joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as if on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he his name, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. For the throne of David and his kingdom, he will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to the God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. comes from the book from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 38, the birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to the town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will become called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Joy is free.
Please join me in the reading of Mary's poem. Pray.
Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors and to his descendants forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home.
Jesus is the story of God with us. It is a reminder of our humanity and our divinity. And in my humanity, I beg forgiveness because I forgot something in the boat. So now we are going to take this opportunity to return a portion of the bounty that has been given to us in gratitude to God for the gifts that have been given and to fulfill obligations that we have made. We're going to return a portion of the storehouses of treasure that have been entrusted to us. Let us now make an offering to God.
Thank you.
Blazers who have been drawn to you, we come bearing gifts. Gifts that are accepted not because of their face value, O God, but gifts that are accepted and embraced because they are given of our hearts. Hearts that are being turned toward you yet again in this season. And so we pray that you would embrace the gifts, the funds that are gathered, as well as the time and the talent that is being offered. We pray that you would grant us wise minds and courageous hearts, so that all the great storehouses of heaven that have been entrusted to the people of faith might be continually put toward the work of the realm come near. And we ask this, O God, that you may be glorified in all things, thought, word, and deed. In the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Please be seated. We observe an open communion table. We understand that the feast that was prepared and laid out in that upper room is a feast that was intended for each and every person. For those who are seeking, for those who are being sought, for those who have already given themselves over to a relationship with God, and for those seeking to renew that relationship. And so all are welcome at this table. Center yourselves, therefore, that you might receive the feast, beginning by singing our voices, joining our voices together in the communion hymn. Who are drawn by the sense of warmth and safety that is there. We are drawn, O God, by others who are present and others who have gone before us. And we pray that as we are gathered together at this table, we might be a single body of Christ, so that in partaking of this bread we might be one, and in sharing in this cup we might proclaim not only the birth that has been, O God, but the anticipated return. We ask this, O God, in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen. On the morning of the resurrection, the disciples went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away, that it was empty, and the cloth folded neatly and laid aside. Earlier on the night that Jesus had been betrayed, he took bread. He gave thanks to you, O God, he blessed you, and then he broke it. And he gave it to those gathered, saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat in remembrance of me."
Thank you.
manner, after the meal, Jesus took the cup. Again, he gave thanks, and then he offered it to them, saying, "This is the cup of a new covenant, symbolizing my blood, which is poured out for the forgiveness of sins. Drink of this, all of you, in remembrance of me."
Thank you.
This season was chosen to mark the birth of Christ for a reason. Because in the northern hemisphere, it is a time when the lights are dimming. The house lights could come down, and even some of the others as well. People of faith gathering in the midst of that, they heard these words of hope. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and without Him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in Him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. And in the midst of the darkness of this season, there is light. Tilt your unlit candles into the light, for it is growing. Is growing out. And as the light fills this sanctuary, we will prepare to sing together our final hymn.
Thank you.
into this place on this evening and we have worshiped the living and loving God. We have sung and we have prayed and we have experienced Scripture. We have dedicated Bibles on this evening with the help of the youth. And now we carry the light of the Christ out of the world from this place, buoyed by the Spirit, emboldened in our faith. So go forth in peace and in hope and in joy and in faith and in love. Go forth in God, proclaiming the good news of God with us. Thanks be to God.